Mariella Frostrup on Times Radio.
Well, as Charlotte Ivers and Carol Walker both mentioned there, would you be persuaded to get jabbed if it increased your chances of finding love? That's what dating app services like Tinder, Bumble and Plenty of Fish are hoping for. They've offered in-app rewards that boost profiles to help people find a match if they can prove they've had the vaccine, that is. One of the participants in the scheme is the Muslim dating app Muzz Match, whose founder and CEO, Shazad Yunus, joins me now. Shazad, tell us first about why you think it's a good idea for dating apps to get involved with the vaccination rollout. It's not really that romantic, is it?
Yeah, thanks for having me, Mariella. It's probably not the most romantic, but I think it is important. You know, let's say single people, I think probably are right at the front of that queue in terms of hoping, you know, we get out of lockdown and some sort of normality and people's, call it normal, social lives resume. You know, for us specifically, you know, we're a Muslim dating app with the biggest in the world. And, you know, we saw it as a kind of a real, I guess, an element of our responsibility in terms of really communicating the messaging around vaccinations, around public health and safety to a community that I think within reason, the government doesn't necessarily always have the greatest kind of track record of talking to. So we thought we'd be useful, helpful to use our platform in a positive way.
Do you think that there was reticence among your subscribers as a result of the government's perhaps not so skilled efforts at communicating with them?
I actually think probably the more the reticence was, I think more around, you know, call it the elements of the lockdown and the various measures that were taking place. I actually think within the vaccine program itself has probably been, you know, the one big positive that's come out of the government's handling of this. I think that's definitely been a strong point on their side. But I think, you know, no doubt there's been a lot of misinformation around the vaccine, be it side effects. And you know, let's say in some communities, you know, Muslim community probably as one of many, where there has been suspicion towards the government in their handling. And, you know, particularly when it comes to, you know, what are very personal, private health matters around vaccinations and people taking injections and jabs. You know, there's a big element of trust when it comes to things like that. For us, I think we definitely saw our role. You know, the UK for us is our biggest market, and you know, we have a very big platform of, you know, hundreds of thousands of young Muslims on our platform. You know, we felt it our duty to help, I guess, spread and use our platform to spread correct information around the vaccine and hopefully encourage people to make an informed choice.
How are you going to, at Muzz Match, how are you going to be in sort of incentivizing people to do that?
Yeah, we haven't. So different dating apps have done different things. You know, some have gone down the road of stickers and you know, call it boosting their profile, etc. You know, we've kind of gone more down the road of how can we use our platform to spread information. So I'll actually be doing, you know, we're using our social media platforms. I'll be doing an Instagram live with a doctor tomorrow, talking about all aspects of the vaccine. Call it tackling the conspiracy theories, tackling people's health concerns around it, and generally answering any sort of questions around that. You know, we've done similar kind of Instagram lives and other live initiatives, talking to medical experts around all aspects, mental health, sexual health. And for us, this is just another important vein to talk around. So we'll be doing that. We'll be using our platform to actually spread in-app messaging around the vaccine, encouraging people. You know, one thing that we're really able to do is really target and message our customers, you know, on a really localized level. So real local messaging to all of our users, I think, hopefully will be received really well.
And just finally, I think you've been working with the NHS because of the relatively low uptake of the vaccine among certain ethnic minority communities. Well, what's that experience been like? What have you learned from them?
Yeah, I think, I mean, no doubt, like I said, you know, it's I guess, communicating to an ethnic minority or minority group in the UK can be quite difficult. You know, I mentioned in terms of call it suspicions or even those kind of links on the ground. You know, one thing we've got is this big platform. So we've had a really good experience working with the NHS and with, I guess, government agencies in terms of spreading this kind of useful knowledge and information to our users. I think one thing that's kind of been, I guess, our members have felt reassured by is a voice that they trust, who can talk to them, I guess, without any sort of pretext, if you will, and more of spreading information and saying, you know, guys, you know, please take this the right way, make your own informed decision, which I think for us just leads to a much better outcome. So we've done that, you know, with the vaccine and with other initiatives where we felt it beneficial to the community. You know, for us, you know, we're a UK startup. You know, I'm a Muslim. You know, we service Muslims in the UK and abroad, and you know, we see it really as part of our responsibility of I guess just helping our community in a positive way.
Shahzad Yunus, founder and CEO of Muzz Match, thank you very much for joining me.